So hey, what's up mga kote? It's me, Ate Mariel, at welcome sa Kote Knows, where learning is the name of the game. So kung bago ka pa lamang sa aming YouTube channel, i-click mo na subscribe, like, and share button para may update ka sa aming mga videos. So samahan natin si Super K sa panibagong araw at panibagong lesson na ating matututunan dito sa Kote Knows. At ang bagong lesson natin for today is all about carbon dioxide. So sa previous nating lesson, na pag-aralan natin yung atmosphere, oxygen, nitrogen. So for today naman, meron naman tayong lesson about sa carbon dioxide. So nabanggit na natin yung atmosphere. Yung atmosphere natin, it is the air and that covers the earth. So yung nitrogen naman natin, so siya yung 78% sa ating gases na nasa atmosphere. So, yung nitrogen natin makes up about 3/4 of the air. So, parang as a whole na siya. And yung oxygen is the most important for the living things. So, dito sa ating video, so dito mapapag-aralan naman natin ng what is carbon dioxide. Ano ba yung natutulong ni carbon dioxide sa plants, sa human, and paano ba to naging important sa atin? So, before we start our video or our lesson, meron muna tayong trivia for today. Pregnancy tests date back to 1300 BCE. According to a document written on ancient papyrus, Egyptian women urinated on wheat and barley seeds to determine if they were pregnant or not. Reports of the Office of History and National Institute of Health: if wheat grew, it predicted a female baby. If barley grew, it predicted a male baby. Nothing was not pregnant if nothing grew. Experimenting with this seed theory in 1963 proved it was accurate 70% of the time. So, ngayon, so yung pregnancy test, na-invent lang siya siguro kalaunan, mga 90s, ganyan. So, nagkaroon lang tayo ng mga pregnancy test kit. So, pa-modern na yung type niya. So, before, wala talagang gamit. If, paano natin malalaman if the women are pregnant, if anong gender ng baby. So, noong 1350 BCE, sa Egypt, so yung mga Egyptian woman, so, nag-test sila sa barley and sa barley and sa wheat. So ayan yung pregnancy test today. So pag pregnant ka, magda 2 line siya. Pag negative naman na pregnant, so magiging pag hindi naman pregnant, so isa lang na bar siya. But before, ito yung ginagamit nila to test if they were pregnant or not. So, according to the experiment, so it was accurate and 70% yung accuracy ng wheat and barley. So, yan ang ating lesson or trivia for today. So, pregnancy tests are date back to 1300 BCE. So, dito na tayo sa ating carbon dioxide. Although carbon dioxide forms only 0.03% of the air, which is a very small amount, it is very important. It is very important for us. You have learned from the study of plants that green plants make their own food with the help of sunlight. So we called it as photosynthesis. One of the raw materials for making food in plant is carbon dioxide. The finished product is sugar and the waste material is oxygen. When animals eat plants and other animals, they also absorb the carbon dioxide in plants. When plants and animals burn or decay, the carbon dioxide in them is returned to the air. Then it is again ready to be used by plants. So process lang siya, paikot-ikot lang siya. So yung raw materials sila, part ng raw materials ng plant for making their own food is carbon dioxide. So, kapag kinain nila ng animals yun, na-absorb nila yung carbon dioxide. So, kapag namatay sila, pag nasunog or na-agnas, of course, na-decay sila. So, yung carbon dioxide ay babalik sa air, and pwede ulit ready to use for plants. So, balik, huwag muna natin i-auto-rotate. So, yan. Off natin. So, ayan. This is the water, the minerals, the sugar, and oxygen. So, ito yung sugar. Ito yung carbon dioxide. So, experiment 78. Is there carbon dioxide in air? So, put some fresh lime water in an open jar or tumbler. Lime water is a lime dissolved in water. So, you can buy this from a drugstore or you may prepare it yourself. To dissolve the lime, to prepare the lime water, get some lime from paint. Supply store. Dissolve a tablespoon full of lime in glass of water. The water will dissolve some lime. Get the clear water. So, water yan. So, nabura ata siya nung nagkaroon ako ng ismudge ko siya sa cam scanner. So, water and remove that undissolved lime. So, now, leave the clear lime water for some time in an open space. Do you notice the milky appearance of lime water? This is because carbon dioxide combines with lime water. So, yan yung ating experiment 78. You can try this at home. Of course, may supervision pa rin ng magulang if you are still a child. So, ayan. You too have carbon dioxide in your body. When you inhale, you take oxygen. When you exhale, you give off carbon dioxide. So, pag inhale, oxygen. Pag exhale, so, carbon dioxide. This comes from the food that you eat and burn in your body to produce energy. So, meron pa tayo experiment number 79. Is there carbon dioxide in the air you exhale? So, prepare some lime water. See how to prepare lime water as described in the experiment in the preceding page. So, with a straw, blow some lime water. So, did the lime water become milky? What does this show? So, yan ang ating experiment number 79. So, other gases. The other gases in air are not needed by living things in their body processes. However, they also need for other purposes. Argon is used in some electric light bulbs. So, neon is also for neon lights, which used for advertising. So, nag-next. And also fluorescent lamp. Helium is used to fill up the balloons and other dirigibles. So, yan. Yung ibang other gases natin, hindi natin ginagamit to process and para maka-live. So, yung iba ginagamit for other purposes to make the human life easier. So, yung helium ginagamit niya sa mga hot air balloons, sa balloon. Yung neon is used for lights. Ay, yung helium talaga yung neon. So, yung ating argon is used for electric light bulbs. So, ayan. So, yan yung for advertising. Yan yung kanyang Lea's Cuisine and Drink Lemon. So, yan yung ating other gases na makikita sa ating atmosphere. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. So, click the thumbs up button if you like this video. And leave a comment down below if you have suggestions, clarifications, and questions to our future videos. So, thank you. Have a great day and God bless. See you in my next video. Bye-bye!